Good morning, good afternoon, good night, wherever you're watching this from. Welcome to Assem Live. This is Assem Sports on this bright, beautiful Saturday. The beautiful game of football and soccer is always in motion and locomotion. The game don't wait. The game is always in motion and the tournament of the moment. Summer is when international tournaments take place and the Euro 2024 has taken center stage. Thank you for tuning into Assem Sports on this bright, beautiful, beautiful, sunny Saturday. Summer is here and the action is packed. The thriller, the manila, the energy, the levels is raising higher to the higher stratosphere. Germany 2024 has lived up to its billing and more. We've seen England bottle two games with abysmal performances yesterday. The almighty France, the question going into the game, is Kylian Mbappe going to play? And if he is unable to play, is this French team stacked enough to do it without him? The answers were given. A 0-0 draw against the Netherlands. The game was entertaining in terms of the tactical mentality between the two coaches, Coleman and Didier Deschamps, both experienced on the field. The French were the far better side. Antoine Griezmann missed two clear-cut chances, two sitters. The French could have buried that game. The Dutch got a goal towards the dying minute. It was ruled out for offside. Controversy surrounding the referee's call. It was a 0-0 draw, but the game was not boring in comparison to the England 1-1 draw with Denmark. I think the French and the Dutch left it all on the field, and it leaves their group open, both on 4 points. So it will be fun. It will be better for the tournament if France and Netherlands both qualify to the next level. England is still sitting on top of the group, but that was yesterday. More blockbuster games are going on today, where it's about to go down between the almighty Portugal, Cristiano Ronaldo's Portugal, a very experienced side, against a Turkish team led by a 19-year-old kid, Andra Guda, the wonder kid of the tournament. And another wonder kid is Lamine Yamal of Spain, who I believe they have been the most exciting team, the most dominant team, the most entertaining team. But one could also say the opposition they played against, they haven't faced a stiffer opposition yet. Heading into the round of 16 and the quarterfinals, we will see who is who. Lots of games are going on today where Georgia, Kvaratskhelia, the Napoli winger, his host nation, they are in action. They are in action against Czechoslovakia. Portugal is going to be playing against Turkey, and later on in the day, Romelu Lukaku's Belgium, who lost their first game and are in need of a stellar performance if they have any hopes of going further in this competition. They are playing against a very strong Romanian contingent. This Euros has been electrifying so far. England has been disappointing, and that has been the conversation across the football sporting world. Gareth Southgate's technical decisions that he makes, his squad selections, they have a final game to play. One could say they are going to qualify to the next stage, but if Gareth Southgate does not change his formation and stop making stupid excuses about Calvin Phillips, really? Calvin Phillips? Calvin Phillips, who Pep Guardiola didn't rate, who went to West Ham, still couldn't get in the squad. Calvin Phillips is the reason why England is not performing. I am not surprised. I don't think anybody is surprised when it comes to Gareth Southgate's obstuity when it comes to changing formation, drawing play. Cole Palmer, Kobbie Mainoo. The tournament has proven to be a tournament of youngsters. If you are going to take a youngster to a tournament, if you are going to be bold enough to drop Jack Grealish and take these young kids, what is the point of taking these young kids if you are not going to play them? What is the point of making such a bold statement if you are not going to stand in it? Thank you for tuning in to Assem Sports, the marquee game of the day. Cristiano Ronaldo's Portugal against Turkey. They both won their first games, vying for who's going to finish in that group. Belgium and Romania are also battling it out, probably for the third best spot to qualify. Who do you think is going to win these Euros? What has been your evaluation so far if you watch all the games that have gone on this bright, beautiful Saturday? Football fans kind of felt there was much more to be desired between the French and Netherlands game, but I enjoyed it from beginning to end. I mean, France could have won it. You know, they were by far the dominant side. The Dutch played well defensively and trying to catch them on the counter-attack, but I was entertained, and there's no way France is going to win this trophy without Kylian Mbappe. It was clear to see. They played one game with him, they won. They played one game with him without, they drawed. I think the answer that is clear. The tasting of the pudding is in the eating. Mbappe should be back. I think France with Mbappe is still the most dominant team. Spain has been beautiful, entertaining. Nico Williams and Lamine Yamal, but I'm yet to see them play against a very strong team. The Italian team, with all due respect, great giants of the game, but of recent years, they haven't been great. So I wasn't surprised that Spain dominated like the Italians today. Cristiano Ronaldo, is he going to be the greatest player in history to score more goals than any player in international tournaments and also professional career? Cristiano Ronaldo's Turkey is playing, Cristiano Ronaldo's Portugal is playing against Turkey, pardon me. Like you already know, the forecast 1.0. New Asha Music Collection available on all platforms. The Euros is here to stay. It's a heat wave. Summer is here. Euro 2024. Obedantele.